Good morning, students. Welcome to the new session. Today, I, Sandhya ma'am, your computer teacher, am going to share some tips for working on the computers. Children, these days, since we are sharing a lot of messages, games, videos through laptops, computers, and mobiles, we surely need to know a proper way to work on it. So let's understand what do we mean by a proper way to work on the computer. This way is known as computer ethics. Here we will learn about what are computer ethics, what is privacy, passwords, download and viruses, appropriate use of technology, equipment safety. Now let's start with computer ethics. What is computer ethic? It is made up of two words, computer and ethics. Now ethics, children, we all know, are the behaviors which are considered to be right in a society. For example, the way we talk, the way we walk, we cannot shout on the roads, we should not run in the corridors. These are all part of ethical behavior. Now when we mix ethics with computer, they become computer ethics. That is, those behaviors which are right for working on the computer. Now before I move on to the next point, children, here there is a picture. You can see in this picture there are children who are trying to use the computer in one or the other way which does not seem to be appropriate, like putting virus in the computer, stealing money from the computer, peeping in somebody's password, or stealing the content of the computer. These are all called as unethical behaviors. Now these computer ethics, these all children will be called as having no computer ethics. So computer ethics, it helps us to protect our privacy and let us use the technology in a proper way. Privacy. Now you will say, what is privacy? Where does the concept of privacy come in? Privacy here, as you can see, children, there is a mobile which belongs to this family. Now the family is using the mobile, but at the same time all the other children who are the outsiders are not allowed to peep inside the mobile. It is locked for all the other outsiders. This is known as privacy. That is, your data remains yours only unless and until you feel like sharing with someone else. So how is this privacy maintained? Now when you are maintaining your privacy, you need to take care that others also need to maintain their privacy. So while maintaining your privacy, you should not indulge into stealing other people's data, or you should respect other people's privacy also. So how can we protect our privacy? By not sharing our personal information online, like your address, your phone number, or your school name. You do not want the whole world to know your address or your phone number. So please do not share such information. Do not take pictures or videos of other people without their knowledge or consent. So as we do not like our information to be shared, similarly others also do not like their information to be shared. So please be very clear, do not take anyone else's information and share it without their consent. It is a crime. Always password protect your documents so that nobody else can open them without knowing the password or without your consent. So children, here you can see how the password is keeping the thief out. It is not letting anyone enter. So this is the way passwords protect our systems. Passwords should be strong enough. Now to make a strong password, it needs to be a combination of capital and small letters, numbers and symbols. The numbers that you use, they should be in the form that you remember. For example, it could be your car number, it could be a part of your mobile number. But remember, the numbers should never be in a series. Use symbols in place of letters. Like here we have used for password The both the S, as you can see, they have become a dollar sign has been used for S. This is a symbol. Now, this we have done. We should not use a series, number series, like 4, 5, 6 should not be used. It is easily traceable. Passwords that are written down, they should be kept in a safe place. First of all, avoid writing passwords, but in at all, if you need to write them, they should be kept at a safe place. Do not share, this is very important, do not share your passwords with your friends or your classmates, however close you may be with them. Do not share your passwords. And do not use your date of birth as your password, as it might be known to many people. Here we can see, children, there are three types of passwords shown here. The first one is crossed. Why? It is not taken to be a secure password. Can you guess why? Rightly, it does not have any capital letter or it does not have any special symbol. It is a simple password written with only small letters. In the second case, we have a capital letter, we have small letters, but the numbers here are in series. Again, there is no special symbol. But the third one, you have a capital letter, you have small letters, you have a special symbol here, as well as the numbers written are not in series. So the third one is taken as a secure password. It is a strong password. Now moving on, from passwords, we come to downloads. It is not our files only, we need to download other people's file also. Downloading means getting information from the net onto your computer. Now, when you are getting the information from the net, it could be in the form of a game, it could be in the form of a file, it could be in the form of a video. But if these applications are downloaded from unknown places, they can cause big problems. Like they can have viruses. Now, what are these viruses? Viruses are computer codes that damage or destroy the information on our computer. Now, how do we prevent from this happening? Children, you need to visit only the safe sites. Safe sites means those sites which are starting with HTTPS. S here stands for security. For example, the site of google.com, here it starts with HTTPS. So this means it is a safe site. Always look for HTTPS when you are downloading something. Do not download any application or file without your parents' permission. Do not change the setting, especially the safety setting, without permission. And always install a good antivirus. Here we have shown some of the antiviruses like Kaspersky, McAfee, Panda. You can use any one of them, but just keep on updating them at regular intervals. Now, besides your software safety, children, you can work on the net or you can download anything from the net only and only if your device is working in a proper condition. So we need to take care of our devices as well. Now, there are certain tips given for taking care of your devices. First, touch the keyboard and the mouse gently. Never ever bang on the keyboard and or the mouse. Do not eat or drink near the computer or the tablets, not even water. Do not disconnect or remove the parts of your system, either the keys from the keyboard or the mouse itself. And always work under your parents' supervision. Knowing all this, be safe, be alert. Use technology in a beneficial way and do not break the rules. Report any site or image that you find inappropriate or you feel uncomfortable working on. It could be any image, it could be a complete site, or it could be even an ad. Just report it to your parents. Use positive and appropriate language when interacting with others. As you like all positive comments about yourself, you need to give the same. Last but not the least, be responsible and respectful towards each other and the equipment.